The clarity within clauses, restrictive and non-restrictive clauses uncovered. Hello, language enthusiasts. Today we'll be diving into the fascinating world of English grammar, focusing particularly on adjectives and adverbs. In our journey to understand grammar better, we're now at the crucial stage of adjective and adverb clauses. Specifically, we will unravel the mystery behind restrictive and non-restrictive clauses. So, buckle up and let's begin. First, let's understand what we mean by a clause. A clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate. It's like a mini sentence within a sentence. Now, when we talk about adjective and adverb clauses, we're essentially discussing clauses that function as adjectives or adverbs in a sentence. That is, they either describe a noun, like an adjective, or describe a verb, an adjective, or another adverb, like an adverb. Let's dive into the world of restrictive clauses first. A restrictive clause, also known as an essential clause, provides essential information about the noun it modifies. This means that if you remove a restrictive clause from a sentence, you may change the whole meaning of the sentence. Restrictive clauses are not set off by commas. Let's take an example. The books that are on the table are mine. Here, "that are on the table" is the restrictive clause. This clause is crucial to understand which books we're talking about. It restricts the meaning to only those books that are on the table. Now, let's talk about non-restrictive clauses. These clauses provide additional information that isn't essential to the meaning of the sentence. Even if you remove a non-restrictive clause, the core meaning of the sentence remains intact. Non-restrictive clauses are usually set off by commas. Let's illustrate this with an example. My dog, who loves to fetch, is very active. Here, "who loves to fetch" is a non-restrictive clause. It adds extra information about the dog, but even without this clause, we still know that the speaker's dog is very active. Well, that brings us to the end of our discussion on restrictive and non-restrictive clauses. They might seem tricky at first, but with practice, you'll master them in no time. Keep practicing, keep exploring, and remember, grammar is the backbone of language, and you're becoming stronger in it every day. Hope you found this video helpful, and as always, keep up your enthusiasm for learning.